Welcome to CBJ in 30.
I'm sure this will be a real bonding experience. Maybe one day, one of you will even write a book about it in jail.
You give us 30 minutes, and we'll give you all you want to know about your Columbus Blue Jackets and the NHL.
Okay, guys, show us what you got.
Now here's your host, who has a few opinions of his own.
Well, Lordy frickin' da!
Bob McElligott.
Those summer nights when we were young, we bragged of things we never done, we were dreamers, only dreamers. And in our haste to grow too soon, we left our innocence on desert moon. We were dreamers, only dreamers on desert moon. On desert moon. On desert moon. Desert moon.
There is Dennis DeYoung and Desert Moon. You remember Dennis. He was the lead singer for Styx. Then he left. Then he might have gone back and then left, whatever, all of that stuff. But anyway, Desert Moon. Why? Because we are headed to the desert today. Welcome to another edition of CBJ in 30. I'm Bob McElligott, and I'll be honest with you, I'm probably going to short shift you on today's show. It probably won't go the entire 30 minutes today because I've got to get to a bus, to the airport, to a plane, to Glendale, Arizona today for the Blue Jackets to practice and get set for their game against the Arizona Coyotes tomorrow night. Let's go through what happened last night. The Blue Jackets, again, with a great start against the Colorado Avalanche, put up two goals in the first period of the game and probably could have had at least three more had it not been for Semyon Varlamov, the starting goaltender of the Avalanche. He was great again last night, and the Blue Jackets had a tough time with him. There's no question. I thought that they were making some mistakes in the first period. I thought all night that they really gave up odd man rushes to the Colorado Avalanche, and that was, well, I guess it was somewhat of a problem. It started to give the Avalanche a little bit of momentum, a little bit of confidence, and throughout the first period, they weren't able to score, and the Blue Jackets scored two different times, and they did it in really two different ways. Brandon Saad got the first goal of the game, kind of a bounce that wound up on his stick, and he winds up burying it. Then later, a three-man rush down the ice. It started as a two-on-one, turned into a three-on-one when Seth Jones joined the play, coming up from behind, and Saad and Jones combined to get it over to Nick Foligno. A great pass from Brandon Saad over to Nick Foligno to make it a 2-0 game, and the Blue Jackets looked like they were in business. They were ready to go. But the Colorado Avalanche, just like they did about a week and a half ago at Nationwide Arena, they came back, and they roared back, actually, with a couple of second-period goals to tie the game at two. The second one coming on a power play when Foligno was in the penalty box for 7 minutes. He got into a fight, which I was fine with, but he got an extra 2 minutes leading into that fight that I totally did not understand. I have no idea why he got the extra 2 minutes. They gave him a two-minute minor for roughing. I thought it was an easy play where his teammate gets hit, he goes over, he challenges the guy, he lets the guy put his gloves down. He didn't jump him before the guy threw his gloves down on the ice, none of that. And he fights, and then he gets an extra 2 minutes. So that was kind of tough to take. That was the one part of the game I was like, what? What is going on here? But anyway, he stood up for his teammate, which is good. He continues to do that as the captain of this club. The Colorado Avalanche use it to their advantage. They get a power play goal. They make it a 2-2 game. Blue Jackets come back in the third period, and a guy that I thought was having zero puck luck all night, Cam Atkinson. I'm telling you, Cam, there were some shots that he tried to take that he didn't get the puck on his stick. There were some passes he tried to make that he didn't get through. There was one time he was skating, he fell down and couldn't skate with a puck. So he was doing, in many regards, absolutely nothing. Nothing was going his way whatsoever. But you know how sports is. Usually it's that guy that's getting zero luck that comes up with a lot of luck at one point of the game, and that's what happened to Cam Atkinson. He gets a puck down in front of the Avalanche net. He's skating by the net, and he turns, and he just throws a blind backhanded pass right toward the top of the crease, and there's Boone Jenner to knock it home, and the Blue Jackets take a 3-2 lead. And with a little bit over 2 minutes left, there was, a draw your breath and hold it type moment for the Blue Jackets. The Colorado Avalanche score a goal because the Blue Jackets couldn't clear the puck outside of their own line. And that was another theme in that game last night. But anyway, they didn't get it out. John Mitchell catches the puck just before it gets to the blue line, throws it toward the net. It gets deflected straight down and in behind Sergei Bobrovsky. And it looks as though the Avalanche have tied the game at 3 goals apiece. But upon further review, former Blue Jacket Blake Como had his stick above the crossbar and above his shoulders. That's where he made contact with a puck. It gets waved off with 2 minutes and 9 seconds left in regulation, and the Blue Jackets are able to ride it out and get themselves a road victory in 2 all-important points against a team that went into the night with tied for the lowest point total in the National Hockey League. That was a must-win game to me. When you're talking about building a bank of points early in the season so that you have those points whenever your slide comes, which it will, that was an important game for me. And they found a way to battle through. They found a way to get it done last night. So it was a good win for the Columbus Blue Jackets. Afterwards, I had a chance to talk about that with Blue Jackets captain Nick Foligno.
Nick, this game was, it was hard fought. I know you're banged up after this game, but what is it about that team that they play you so hard?
I think they're a team trying to find themselves. So I think we just, it was ugly. I'll be the first one to admit. I think we kind of got a little soft there at the end of the second and didn't play our game and allowed them to come back into it. And we have to play our style all game long. And that's what happens. When you get away from it, teams can take advantage. And that's a good lesson against a team like that who's trying to find themselves and is going to, breed and kind of feast on mistakes that we're making. And that was really what it was. It was all mistakes we made, and it gave them the game.
And they get that goal that looks like they tie the game, and then it gets taken off the board. And I said at that point, I feel like if you want to be a good team, now you got to ride it out and you got to find a way to win that game of regulation, which you did. So yeah. Do you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. I thought there was a huge message from Torts. He kind of came in here and just said, simplify it. 20 minutes to win a game, and you make that your first period. Treat the third period like a first period and just come back and, put the bass two behind you and get ready to play. So it was a good message, I think, for a lot of guys. We refocused, and big goal by those guys, and I'm happy we got the win.
Yeah, and at the end of the day, you get 2 points on the road, and that's all that matters, right?
Yeah, exactly. Gags is tripping me over here. What's going on?
Else is new, right?
What else is new? No, I think that's you got to be proud of that. I mean, you got to find ways to win in this league. It's not always going to be pretty. I'm proud that we found a way to recoup and get back to a big win here that we needed for our club to move forward. We're a team that's desperate to move up, and it's nice to see us find a way to get an ugly one.
Thanks, Nick.
Thank you.
Let me tell you, he was banged up after that game, putting ice on where he had blocked a shot. I mentioned he was in a fight. He was the consummate hockey warrior in that game last night for the Blue Jackets, no question. When you talk about leading by example, Nick Foligno did just that in last night's game. Also, there was a little clip that made its way to Twitter last night of Nick on the bench. He went to take a drink out of a water bottle. As he was squeezing the bottle, the top blew off the bottle, and the water went all over him. And after the game last night, we ran into him, and Jody Shelley and I were talking to him about that, and he was mad that it happened, but he never let it be known that he was mad on the short clip on TV. But he's just going to try to get a drink, and the water bottle blows up on him. It was one of those nights where he could do, could do almost nothing right, but he got a big goal in that game, and that was certainly right for the Blue Jackets. Another guy, as I told you a few minutes ago, that got a big goal was Boone Jenner. His hard work finally paid off last night, and I talked with him after the game.
Boone, big win for you guys here tonight. You have that all-important goal that breaks the 2-2 tie, and there was a point there where it seemed like you guys just couldn't get in sync and couldn't get anything together, and that goal kind of changed all that, didn't it?
Yeah, I think we got off to a good start, and it kind of got away from us in the second period with our decisions and stuff like that, and they took it to us a bit. But I thought we did a good job of wiping the slate clean and coming out and just focusing on the last 20 for kind of a fresh start, and we played like it.
It looked like one of the things tonight that you guys battled with was clearing your own zone. Your captain, Nick Foligno, gives you a little bit of grief here, but clearing your own zone was kind of a problem tonight. But they were on you with a heavy forecheck, weren't they?
Yeah, we know that they come hard, and they got some big bodies that like to forecheck, and at times you could see the quickness they were on us, and we were just at times, I guess, struggling to make that quicker play to get out of our zone, but. All in all, I think, especially in the third period, we just bared down and made the right decisions.
How big is this win? You get it on the road, you get it against a team that, quite frankly, on paper, you should beat, and you find a way at the end of the day.
Yeah, I think it's just, you know, it's a game for us. And, you know, no matter who we're playing, you know, what the situation is, if we're coming off a win, coming off a loss at home, on the road, I think we're trying to get that same mindset going into every game. And, you know, that preparation that, you know, we're getting ready to win. And I think that's good. And I think that's, you know, a little bit of our starts as well. You can kind of see it in that.
And finally for you, there were times earlier in the year you were struggling to find your game, but it's back and you've been working hard. How nice does it feel to get rewarded with a goal for the hard work?
Yeah, it's definitely nice, especially, you know, 2-2 game in the third period to contribute like that. And, you know, I think it's, you know, had some opportunities and, you know, it's, you know, it was nice to see one go in.
Boone, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm so glad that he got that goal. I mean, his game has come back to where it's supposed to be. He has battled. He has won the individual battles on the wall. He has done all of the things that he needs to do, and he got rewarded last night with not only a big goal, but a game-winning goal on a great pass, a fantastic pass from Cam Atkinson. And that's just the familiarity of that line, right? Boone knows where Cam is going to put that puck, so he makes sure that he gets to that spot. And Dubinsky was going to the spot, too. It could have been either one of those guys. Boone just happened to get there a little bit more quickly than Brandon Dubinsky did. So fantastic goal by Boone Jenner, and good to see again, because as his, he was slow in starting. We've talked about that a million times. He was probably close to being either scratched, or he was certainly getting his ice time cut back, but that is not happening any longer. I was curious to see what John Tortorella would have to say after the game last night, if he would be happy with the effort, if he would think it was a little bit lacking. But you know what? As this goes on and his team finds ways to win, I think Torts cuts them more and more slack because of the effort that they're putting out. Here's the press conference John Tortorella had after last night's game.
It seemed like you just wrestled that game away in the third period. Momentum had shifted and you just wrestled it back in the third.
Yeah, I thought we played well right on through. We didn't give them much. I thought we had the puck most of the evening. You know, they score a power play goal, gives them some life. And you knew after we go up 2-0 and the saves that their goalie made to keep them at 2-0, you knew something funky was going to go on in the game. So a good way to win it, how it all turned out. We lose a two-goal lead. I still don't think we were playing that poorly even when we lost a two-goal lead. We just stayed with it, and I thought we had a really good third period. And yeah, so we'll take it and go.
How about the shift from Dubinsky's line right after the power plays passed for you?
Yeah.
There was a real momentum.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah, even our power play, we go over, but we had some chances, and Cam had some chances, and then penalty at, you know, 5-on-3, and yeah, the we didn't lose any momentum. We just said, okay, let's clear the boards here. We didn't get things done there. Let's just keep on playing. And I thought Doobie's line had some really good momentum shifts throughout the game.
John, when you see Cam so frustrated as he was when he came off the ice there, and then he pulls it together to make
makes
that
a
assist.
Big play. Yeah. Yeah. And that's what you look for. He had a number of chances that he just couldn't get done, but makes a huge play. It's great to see Jen score a goal. He worked very hard tonight in the boards. Yeah. So I'm real happy that we didn't lose our patience. We didn't open up in the third period and really give them much at all. We just went back to our game. We talked about in between periods, wipe everything clean. We have one period to play. Let's consider it the start of a game. And let's get to our meeting as we had at the start of the game and get back to it. And I thought we were strong in that third period. So I thought they deserved to win the hockey game.
So the coach was happy with what his team did last night. And again, the final result is they get 2 points. They get 2 points that they should get against a team like the Colorado Avalanche. And now they've got the next two games where they should get 2 points in each one of those. And those are coming up against the Arizona Coyotes. That'll be tomorrow night, 8 o'clock game in Glendale, Arizona. And then the Coyotes actually come back to Columbus, and the two teams will face off at Nationwide Arena on Monday. These are all important points, again, because this team, just like the Colorado Avalanche from last night, not where they want to be in the standings. They are sitting near the bottom of the league. You have got to get points against these types of teams. Now, that being said, it's not the easiest thing in the world. I mean, when you look at the Arizona Coyotes, to me, look in net, Mike Smith is there. And he, I know he can go, he can be hot or cold, like really any goalie, but And he's dependent upon how the team plays in front of him, which hasn't been good. But all of that being said, he is a good goaltender, another big goaltender that does a good job. And if you don't get him moving, if you don't get multiple shots on him, second and third opportunities, you're going to have your work cut out for you. Oliver Ekman-Larsson is a star on the Arizona Coyotes. He had been out hurt. He came back last night. They'll have to deal with him. Again, it's not like you walk in. There is no team that you walk in the NHL. You lace up your skates. You go out on the ice and you just win because you showed up and you're a better team than them. It does not work that way. Anybody can win on any given night. The Blue Jackets have to be very cognizant of that. I'm sure they will be. They're going to practice today. They are going to be reminded of that whole thing. And one thing that this team has been able to do well, and we've talked about it, and I talked with Sam Gagner before the game last night about this, this team has been very good at moving beyond yesterday today. Now, what do I mean by that? I mean that yesterday was a good win. They found a way. They got the points. They're happy about it. But today will be a new day. Today will be a different approach. Today will be, let's get ready for the Arizona Coyotes. They know that they can't just ride the wave of yesterday's game because that wave has already hit the beach. And there's a new wave coming. And they've got to get on the next wave and find a way to turn that into another win. So that's been the mindset of this team. And I love that mindset. I love the fact that they're embracing that. I love the fact that they're doing the things that they have been doing. And they need to do them again tomorrow, quite frankly. Coming back from this trip, if you come back to Columbus for Monday's game and you have picked up four out of a possible 4 points, you've done a great job. And that is the mission. They know exactly what the mission is. And they will be ready. I know they're going to be ready. You know, there have been times in the past where I say I hope they're ready. I know they're going to be ready for this game tomorrow. These guys are, they are feeling it. They are really feeling it. I'm telling you. I saw Dan Hynote last night, former Blue Jackets assistant coach. He was here in Denver, and we were talking after the game. And I said that to him. He said, man, it's nice to see these guys play how they're playing. I said, they believe in it, don't they? He said, they do. They do. And he would know. He won a Stanley Cup, right? He won a Stanley Cup with the Colorado Avalanche. He knows what it's like. He knows what it takes. So it'll be a very good game tomorrow in Arizona, I'm sure. Blue Jackets and the Coyotes get set to go. That's tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. We'll have the game for you on the Blue Jackets Radio Network. It is time for me to head out, go to the airport. So I hope you enjoy this abbreviated version of CBJ and 30. Until tomorrow night, I'm Bob McElligott saying so long.